Vsauce. I'm Jake, and after watching Captain America's Civil War, I got to thinking about Cap's shield and how powerful of a weapon it is. According to Marvel, the shield weighs 12 pounds, has a diameter of 30 inches, a blunt edge, and in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, is made entirely out of the fictional metal vibranium. And from watching the movies, we know how strong it is. It can block bullets, robot arm punches, and Thor's hammer, which we learned is incredibly powerful. But when wielded properly, the shield can also be used as a very effective weapon that's able to literally disarm an alien, cut through elevator cables, stick into the side of a car, and cut a robot in half. All of that got me thinking about something in particular. If the shield can cut a robot in twine, what would happen if Captain America's shield hit you? Now, the first thing you're probably thinking is that since Captain America is a very well-trained super soldier, he probably throws his shield with less power at a human being than at a sentient machine. And I thought the same thing. So using the amazing open source physics software Tracker, I calculated how fast the shield was traveling, not only when being thrown at normal people, but also at supervillains and inanimate objects. It turns out that they were all around the same speed, which flies through the air at an average 18.4 meters per second, or 41 miles per hour. So now we have a giant spinning 12-pound disc flying at you at 41 miles per hour. What would happen to your body when it makes contact? The results I got were very surprising, so much so that I reached out to two people very well versed in physics, Dr. Martin Archer and Diana from the awesome channel Physics Girl, to verify. And what we discovered was that nothing too devastating would happen. It would have around the same kinetic energy as a professional boxer's punch. That being said, if the edge of the shield were to hit you in the head, it would most likely kill you or give you at least severe brain trauma. But anywhere else and you would still be alive. You'd just be pretty bruised and probably a little bit sad. So you wouldn't have to really worry about his shield too much. But he has something else that would be even more devastating. His foot. Using Tracker, I was able to calculate the speed at which a villain traveled backwards after being kicked by the captain, and it was pretty fast at 16.5 miles per hour, and the acceleration from 0 to 16.5 was almost instantaneous, which would not be good for your well-being. You'd experience about 9 Gs of force immediately, 1 G more than what an F-16 pilot experiences pulling out of a dive. To put that into perspective, an average person would pass out after 5 Gs. Not only that, but if he kicked you with the complete surface of his foot, it would most likely break every bone it came into contact with. However, it gets worse. Let's say just the heel of his foot hit you, since the surface area is now much smaller, but he's still transferring the same amount of energy, the damage done would not be great for you. His heel would be able to break through 1.5 inches of solid bone. So if he were to kick you here in the sternum, his foot would most likely go into your body. But don't worry, it wouldn't make it all the way through because your spine would stop it. If his foot was aimed somewhere else, say at your head, well, you can probably imagine. But if you can't, when it comes to Captain America's shield, it is surprisingly less damaging than I expected. To be honest, I imagined a 12-pound flying disc with an edge even though dull the size of my pinky would cause more bodily harm, but the math told me otherwise. His foot, however, well, the captain might stand for freedom, but the only freedom he'd be dispensing is freedom from living. And, as always, thanks for watching.